Hi, I'm Abby Stopher. I'm the Senior Product Marketing Manager for doTERRA Europe. And today I am joined by Dr. Fernando Guerra and Dr. Alexandra Nisha. Hello.
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 Both are members of our Scientific Medical Education Committee. And we are really excited to be here today because we are going to be talking about the microbiome and two supporting doTERRA products, PB Restore and PB Assist Plus. So Alexandra, we hear a lot, and especially recently, around the microbiome, but can you help explain to me and to us what that means, what it is?
In order to understand the microbiome, imagine the microbiome as a big, bustling city with a lot of tiny little citizens called microbes, viruses, fungi, and they live there together in communities and balance and harmony. And they have different challenges and they have different jobs there to do. And they live all over us. So we have them in our gut, for example. We have them all over our skin. We have them in the female reproductive system, and we have them also in our lungs. And they have different challenges there, but the most important thing, what they are doing, is protecting us. And if they live in harmony, then we have a healthy microbiome. And if they're getting out of balance, then some of them could harm us.
And how does the microbiome interact with our bodies?
The microbiome is interacting all the time with our bodies. For example, it's communicating all the time with our immune system. And this is so important because over 70% of our immune system is in our gut. And there we also have a really big city, so a really big microbiome. And this communication is so important for the overall health, for a healthy immune system. It's also supporting our metabolism. It's also supporting our sleep system. It's helping us having a good mood or a good behavior. And it depends where the microbiome is. So for example, the microbiome in the gut is more there also for digesting food or there for absorbing nutrients. And the microbiome on our skin is more for protecting us from strangers from outside, because our skin is a natural barrier, is our biggest organ we have, protecting us from all the pathogens outside. And a healthy microbiome on our skin leads to a healthy skin and also to a healthy barrier. And yeah, and that's so on, depending on where our microbiome is, this overall health is the most important thing what we have in the communication with our microbiome and our bodies.
So it sounds like they've got a pretty important job to play.
They have, yeah.
So Fernando, can you talk us through some lifestyle habits that would support a healthy microbiome or potentially negatively impact our microbiome?
So the importance of our microbiome is the variety.
Okay.
The variety of species. Like Alexander said, we have lots of species that live there in communion, do all the jobs for the our body, help us to produce certain vitamins and other substances that are important for us. And one of the most important factors that can help that microbiome is diet. Have a healthy diet.
Okay.
Another is movement, activity, sport. There's a lot of studies that says that if you do more exercise, you increase the number of more species that live in your gut. They're more healthy. So if those communities are more healthy, we are more healthy. So for contrary, if you do exercise, if you have a heavy toxic load exposed to the bad things that we are exposed every day.
Yeah.
Sometimes we don't feel it immediately, but on the long way we will feel it.
That's really interesting because as the topic of microbiome has become more popular, I think we've all heard that having that variety of plants and food in your diet, but interesting that those extra lifestyle habits like exercise, reducing your toxic load also has a big impact on
just
health
all the,
as well.
The health chart that we have in doTERRA.
Yeah, sounds like it.
Yeah.
Alexandra, what happens when we don't have a healthy microbiome?
Yeah, so when the little citizens get in trouble because they have war or they have disharmony there, getting out of balance, then this could cause an unhealthy microbiome. And this can lead different issues. If we talk about our gut, then we could have problems within our digestion. So this can lead symptoms like diarrhea, or a constipation, or bloating, or IBS, or IBD. If we have problems with our microbiome on our skin, then this can lead to different infections. This can lead to issues like acne and psoriasis. So it's so important. We can't give every fault to our microbiome, but if our microbiome is not in balance, we have issues. We don't connect this to our microbiome. So we see maybe only on our skin something, but the problem is not the skin, it is the microbiome. With the gut, it's easier because we know that we have a microbiome in our gut. And when we have a problem with our digestion, so we think about that it could be the microbiome. But I think it's important to have a closer look on our microbiome because of this big challenges and this big jobs, what they have to do. And if we are protecting it and helping the citizens to have more harmony in their community, then this is the best for us.
Another thing important is also that community, that huge city that lives in all of our body. If there's imbalance, for instance, if you have any condition, if you need for take a certain type of medicine in that particular time, that can unbalance that. So there's a lot of guidelines that says when you prescribe, as doctor, we prescribe a certain type of medicine, you should provide probiotics because that medicine can alter that community and at the long run will make another type of issues. Don't forget one thing. There's a lot of risk factor for some conditions that are related with the microbiome. For instance, if there's a cesarean or a normal delivery, if you're breastfeeding your child or not. So those risks, those positions since the baby time will just give you all the support or not, have more risk or not to acquire some conditions. So it's important, the microbiome, because when we born, we don't have that much, we are not so much colonized, but with time we'll be colonized, and that will help us in our gut, in our respiratory system, in our mouth, in all of our organs that are exposed to the exterior, and they are exposed to every type of microbiome, that of microbes that are in our environment and can be good or bad for us.
And if we talk about a healthy microbiome and we talk about all the benefits like having a good behavior or having a good sleep, then it's totally logical that if we have an unhealthy microbiome, that the opposite can happen. So it can lead to a restless night. It can lead to a bad mood. It can also lead to things like anxiety or depression. You mentioned so nice a wellness chart. What are inside our wellness chart can topple if we have an unbalanced microbiome.
Yeah, and if you see every day all the papers that are coming out all the time, they show the importance of the microbiome and the importance of taking probiotics. And the thing is the type of probiotics and the quality. That's what we are here to talk about, because not everything is the best. Not only the best species are good for us.
I think the topic of microbiome is fascinating.
Yeah, it is.
And there's a reason why it's become such a big topic that we've seen so many studies come through. Yeah. I've seen so much information come through. And hearing you, Alexandra, talk about it as this community that lives on your skin and in your body and all of these different citizens that are at play and the different effects that it can show if you do have that imbalance and unhealthy microbiome in your body. So, Fernando, could you tell us what makes our PB Restore product so unique?
This product is so unique because of the mechanism of delivery. We have on this product the prebiotics, the probiotics, and the postbiotics. The prebiotics helps the probiotics to live. They're likely their food. And the postbiotics are some elements that are produced by the probiotics to help the body. That capsule has a double layer. When you take it, it will be delivered on the gut on the precise time. Because when you take your pill, it will go to the stomach. The stomach is very acid and mostly destroys everything. And that double layer capsule gives a protection to that capsule, to those bacteria that we want to repopulate to help the microbiome will be delivered on the right place, in the right conditions, in the right number. Because sometimes we just see capsules with probiotics selling everywhere with a really big amount of seafood, which is the number of colonies. And at the end, at delivery time, there's not that much like we have. We certify that the number of bacteria that are good for our microbiome are delivered on the number that we presented.
And that's able to be achieved because of that?
Yeah, that technology, yeah. The delivery system is really key. Because you cannot, if you don't have this type of system, it's difficult for you to deliver the amount that you need.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So, Fernando, can you help explain to me the differences between PB Assist Plus and PB Restore?
Of course. So, PB Assist Plus is a powder, a sachet with a powder, mm-hmm. and each grain is microencapsulated. So, it's the system, the delivery on the right spot. So, this product has strains that are used for our gut microbiome. And the PB Restore is, like I said, a double layer capsule that also be placed and open on the right spot on the gut. The difference in terms of strains is the, like I said, PB Assist Plus is more for the gut, mm-hmm. but PB Restore can use it all abroad of species, not only for the gut, but also for the skin, for respiratory tract, and genitourinary tract. So it gives you a full amount of species that can help your microbiome.
And am I right in saying that PB Restore has 28 strains mm-hmm. and PB Assist Plus has 13?
Correct.
And they're both different.
Yeah,
so they
different.
Offer those yeah. different strains. So if I take both, mm-hmm. I would receive that variety yeah. that we need to yeah. support our healthy yeah. microbiome and give us that great community that you've both explained so mm-hmm. well as well. So Alexandra, what are the benefits of being able to use both of these products together?
So yes, you can choose the product what you would like to have depending on your habits or also on your issues. So the combination is interesting because if we would like to support our microbiome in a different way, so if we would like to support not only the microbiome in our gut, but also in our lungs, in our skin, or at our skin and in other places in our body, then the combination could be a really great support. But if we say, okay, I would only like to take the PB Assist because I would like to support my gut in a daily basis, but I have no problems with my lifestyle and with my habits, then I think the PB assist could be enough. But sometimes we have challenges in our life and we can feel that. And maybe now the people know that if they have issues like a restless sleep or problems with their mood or also a stressy life or a problem with digestion, then they know, okay, maybe now in my life I need a little bit more support, or maybe I need a support overall health. And for that, I think a combination is a really a great opportunity for the people to supporting the microbiome in such a different way and in such a full of variety way.
Absolutely. And Fernando, how would you recommend using the two products?
It's really easy. It's a capsule, the BB Restore is a capsule that you can use it. I recommend take it at lunch, for instance, okay. Because it will take time when you take the pill, goes to the stomach and then to the gut to open. So it takes time. Why don't take it at dinner? Because you're going to take your dinner. Then after a couple of hours, you're going to sleep. So when you go to sleep, the velocity of the movement of your gut will be slower. So it will not deliver the amount that we need. So the product will not function as we want it. So it's better to take in the early hour. The PB Assist Plus, you can take with all the family. In a smoothie, yeah, with some fruits, of course, you need to take it with temperature, environment temperature or cold temperature, because we are dealing with living microorganisms. So you don't want to kill it. So it will be a waste. And that's important.
So don't add it to any hot drinks.
Please don't.
Anything like that. Okay, noted. But you've mentioned that that's family friendly, yeah, as well, which I think is great. And it's something that we can take directly from the sachet.
Yeah, you can take directly.
It's really easy.
You can put it in a smoothie.
Yeah.
What I recommend on the beginning, because you're taking a great amount of bacteria for your gut,
yeah,
you can start with a half sachet at the first days, and then you can go with the full sachet. So after 4 years old, the PB Assist Plus, you can easily, or even younger, there's no big issue. Okay. If you mix it with the baby food, it will be great. It will help a lot the gut, because I deal with kids every day. I work with kids every day. And the gut issues is a great issue for the parents. The bloating, sometimes we don't know why they are crying. And sometimes they are the gut. They are pain because their microbiome are still on growing. They are building the city there.
Yeah.
So like we have a city with buildings. Yeah, it's problematic in that time.
They're still in construction.
Yeah, okay. So it's important to just give them this product.
That's great.
It's great.
And one thing I wanted to mention as well is as we've had this discussion, we've spoken a lot about probiotics throughout this. And I think one thing that's important to note is that in Europe, and as part of our, what you'll see on the packaging for PB Restore and PB Assist is not probiotics. Mm-hmm. We say live bacterial cultures.
Mm-hmm.
It means the same thing. It's just slightly different for Europe as it is in other countries as well. But thank you both very much for your time today.
So
it's been great chatting with you.
Thank you.